So, checking out now, again, someone who spent $100,000 on Diablo Immortal, not thinking it's that bad. Can't wait to see their reasoning, and I can't wait to see if Stu Gaming reacts to this video we're about to watch as well. So, without further ado, let's get started. As always, I'm your host, Dr. Duality. Please be sure to follow, like, subscribe, all that. Really means a lot. So thank y'all. Let's get to it.
Video is for you. Let's find out what it's about.
Now, I've been having a ton of fun on Twitch. Mm-hmm. I've only been Twitching now, or I've only live streamed on Twitch now for five days. And every single day has gotten better and better.
Dang. Well, that's what's up. Hey, right on. I just hit the 2-week mark. It's fun. Now, I guess this guy, clearly, you know, if you really want to get popular, it just goes to show. just like in Diablo Immortal. Spend more money, drop $500,000 or drop $100,000, and people are going to take notice. So apparently I've been doing all this wrong. I just need to be dishing out a lot more cash.
The crowd's grown. And
look at this dude's resonance. 5,000 fucking resonance.
That's unreal.
Look at his fucking pearls. 1.2 million? Wait a second. Okay, how much do you, okay, so just 1 second. It's 6,000 plus 1,200? Yes? Okay.
Jesus.
He's sitting on 16 grand just sitting there?
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the whale.
It's just sitting there. That's off the top. That's money right off the top. That's, oh my mother, what a gamer. Oh my fucking God. Beyond mortal comprehension? Holy shit, dude.
It's been a ton of fun, okay. Like I was saying.
Let me see this.
I wanted to make this video specifically for a lot of the computer haters that I have seen. A lot of people that play computer games are hating so hard.
Stu's gonna love this guy.
Oh, dude, it's like these computer nerds.
Stu's gonna love him.
They're getting up in their feelings like it's high school again. When are we gonna be able to throw these computer nerds in the garbage can again? Wait, what is this, computer gamers? What do you mean? Where do you think they made Diablo Immortal? They made this shit on a computer.
Dude.
I understand their view, okay. Because honestly, I've been a computer gamer my entire life. I'm mainly talking about Asmongold and also a little bit of Rich Campbell and Quinn. I mean, all these guys are.
So he's calling out all of Allcraft. Mm-hmm. Like he's coming down. He's not just on me. Like he's on every.
He's a whale. He's going for the big kahunas, right? He's hungry, clearly. So, he's gonna take on everyone. Smart marketing. I mean, hey, you shout out as many people as you can, and hopefully one bites. Good for the channel.
Everybody on Allcraft, like, he's like, yo, these guys, we've had enough of their shit, except Josh. Yeah,
guys that I've been a fan of for years. I think all three of them are absolutely hilarious.
Okay,
I love watching their live streams.
Thank you.
And I think they're really good dudes
as well. But
I think they have a one-sided point of view of how mobile gaming works and the different.
Yeah, I know, pausing a lot, but this stuff is just too funny to pass up. It's a good old was it criticism sandwich? It's like, I think there's an issue, but listen, they're great. They're fantastic. You know, they're great people. I think they're all idiots. I think they're horrible. I don't think they know what they're doing. But lastly, you know what? They've created some great videos. Right? You just got to shove all the insults and criticisms right in between.
Differences in computer and mobile gaming now.
Okay.
I've been in computer gaming since 1990.
If the difference between mobile gaming and computer gaming is that in mobile gaming you have to spend money, why is that the difference? Why? But that's my main question. But why?
Asking too many questions.
High school. Mm-hmm. And I used to travel the United States playing a game called Counter-Strike.
Oh, nice. Right.
That's what's up.
Counter-Strike 1.3 and 1.6.
Yes.
I used to play at the Cyber Athlete Professional League in Dallas, Texas. It was the first ever million-dollar tournament.
Holy shit.
In Texas. And my team placed eighth, right? And we won like $15,000 a piece for five members.
That's a lot.
But for back then, yeah, that's huge. Not to mention the first, like, hey, mad respect, right? And that's one thing I also respect about Sue Gaming is like being, you know, chill, not dishing out too many attacks. But they've been around the block, right? They're not just like someone coming here just like dishing it out. It's just like, nah, man, these are gamers and they're presenting their opinions in a very valid and, you know, was it a, oh man, I'm a cordial way. There you go.
Huge
deal.
But back then, you got to keep in mind, like, gaming was not what it is now. Like, 15 grand back then was a lot. That was ridiculous.
Yeah, and then we were in Cal Invite, and we constantly did big things with Counter-Strike. Well, then
the reason he's bringing all this up, right, is because, like, he's trying to make himself, and, like, I'm not saying this is the wrong thing, right? He's just giving his, effectively, like, his resume, so it's not like, oh, I'm just, like, some random guy. Like, he's like, yeah, I actually, like, I know what I'm talking about, right?
It's
like,
a quick background. It's, it's fine.
He wants to be an expert witness, exactly.
Oh, God.
His credibility. Diablo 2, not competitively. Okay. I just stopped playing Counter-Strike competitively because it didn't lead me nowhere. And
it's
honestly,
hard.
We ended up falling apart, right? And the game kind of, I just grew out of the game. But however, I still play the game to this day. And I've played it pretty much my whole life as well. But not only Counter-Strike, I've also played tons of different computer games such as World of Warcraft, Diablo 2, Diablo 3. Mm-hmm. I've played Warcraft 3, I've played Starcraft 2, I've played Hearthstone, and I've played all these games at a level to where it's player v player, obviously, player versus player, and massively competitive, right? I was a gladiator in World of Warcraft on the Blackrock server. I was
BG9.
In Rekful's guild, Byron's guild, called Sup Fresh, our turn, baby. I had
My god, that fucking dude, old man. Like, that was on BG9. That shit was hard.
Much respect.
Oh my god, that was hard.
Team all right, let's see it. In the brutal gladiator season, it was when feral druids were overpowered. I was a resto druid named Butta. And then I had another, or he had another buddy that was a feral druid, and we ran rogue double druid.
And I can see that happening.
Merciless gladiator,
ouch,
vengeful gladiator, a brutal gladiator, and so forth, right? And then I ended up quitting WoW after Wrath of the Lich King. All I played WoW for was Arena, right?
Book, thanks for
so this is kind of just, all this stuff is useless information, what I'm saying, but I'm just kind of giving you guys a background that I have been a part of computer
You have used a computer before.
The last 20 years, right?
Okay.
By the way, I respect all you guys to the utmost. So, all
right, so now he's about to talk shit.
I've never made a video like,
here we go.
Yeah, he gets it. He gets
talking about people's perspective. I kind of just only focus on gaming. However, all the trash talk for mobile gaming just isn't necessary, in my opinion, as far as like Diablo Immortal.
Okay.
I've also played mobile gaming a lot. Not only do I play a lot of computer gaming, but I play a lot of mobile gaming.
Okay.
Been a part of a game called Clash of Clans. Have over
there it is.
Figures invested into it.
He not only is a pro gamer, he is a pro spender. And again, you know what? It's his money. Do with it what you want. But I mean, hey, he just gave us the, you know, quick peek of the resume. And it is what it is. Again, still don't agree with it whatsoever. But, I mean, the guy's at least being pretty cool about everything so far. Like, very clearly not trying to be a jerk to anyone. So I always respect that, right? Because quickest way to lead a conversation to nowhere is to just start name-calling and being ugly, because then no one's gonna listen, no one's gonna respect your thoughts. Even if you have a good one, it's like, well, you're a jerk, so, you know, I don't really care what you have to say. So pretty interesting, but obviously, all right, let's get to the juicy meat of it.
Oh.
He's breaking. He's evolving, losing a couple hairs maybe. That's too mean.
How do you spend $100,000 on a fucking video game? I don't even know what to say.
Invest in oil. In the oil business, and then $100,000's nothing. That's chump change. He said Dallas, Texas. So Dallas is, believe me, I know. There's money to be had there. Lots of it.
Say, I'm just in shock. RuaPug, 5 subs. Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
Over the course of a while, right? And so, had an absolute blast with that game. But again, completely different perspective.
Okay.
And now Diablo Immortal has come out. I've been a Diablo fan my entire life. Played D1, played D2, D3.
All right.
Mm-hmm. I was big into D3. Had a couple level 99 hardcore characters. Had one of the best level 18 duelers in the world as an assassin. Used to buy and sell items every day.
Wait, what? B2J
duelers in the world. 99 hard 2. Played D. Come out. I've been a Diablo fan my entire life. Played D1.
This guy knows what he's doing.
D3.
That's impressive.
Big into D3. Had a couple level 99 hardcore characters. Had one of the best low level.
That was Diablo 2. Yeah, I guess he must be saying Diablo 2 because Diablo 3, it's not how it worked. Okay.
Duelers in the world as an assassin. Used to buy and sell items every day off D2JSP. Had an absolute blast. Used to buy all kinds of stuff off Kriparian nonstop. He always had the goods. I'd always buy.
Oh, Kriparian.
I remember Krip. I don't remember that being true. I don't remember Krip ever having good gear to sell. I remember Krip selling stupid shit and people buying it. Whenever the Real Money Auction House came out, he would sell stupid shit and people would buy it.
Playing Diablo 2. Some of my best childhood memories, right?
Okay.
Well, anyway, mobile gaming is a completely different type of vibe. You go in downloading mobile gamings knowing that there's a pay-to-play perspective and there's a free-to-play perspective.
Why? Like, and this is the question that I feel like nobody seems to be able to ask. Like, we know that there are mobile games that are pay to win. Everybody knows this. But have you ever stopped to take a second and think, why?
And then there's like a mediocre, like...
Yeah, very good Diablo times.
Minnow. We got, like, free-to-play players, then we got minnows, then we got dolphins.
Minnows are Battle Pass Andes, right? Minnows, you know, they buy the Battle Pass
present
every time, and that's about it, right? Maybe they buy, like, a Collector's Edition Battle Pass, but that's it.
Dolphins, you know, then we got whales, and then we got the big boys. Then we got the mega whales, right?
The big boys.
Multiple different mobile
the big boys.
Players.
All right.
I'm just saying, I still like the term Leviathans. I think that's just the perfect.
Well, a good mobile game can find how to mix all of these players into one game to have fun together in all sorts of different ways, right? And so what I've found is I've played probably 4 or 5 different really good mobile games that have been able to do that, right? Clash of Clans being one of
Raid
them.
Raid Shadow Legends.
Clash being one of them.
Uh-huh.
Clash Royale being one of them.
Whale Wars,
multiple games that have just figured out that niche. Well, I just wanted to say this. Diablo Immortal is one of those games.
So I feel like this is what a lot of mobile gamers say, is that basically mobile games are pay to win because they're pay to win. It's like a tautological argument that like, well, they're pay to win.
You don't hear that getting passed around too often. Tautology. Or tautological. You get just very circular stuff, but he'll fill you in on it.
Because they're pay to win. It's circular logic. There's nothing that yes, we know this, but why? Mobile games are pay to win? Why? Well, because they're pay to win. But why? Why is it like this?
And here's why. I'll explain.
It's just crazy.
I saw the video of Rich and Asmongold.
Uh-oh.
Basically, Rich had invested, I don't know what he invested, like $15,000 or something.
Dude.
Never went into the battlegrounds in this game ever before. And yeah, he just went in there and started basically multi-shotting and killing everybody.
Yeah, he sure did.
And so they were laughing at the video, making fun of it, and being like, oh, this is what it's like being a pay-to-play. Yeah. Well, you just one-shot everybody. Look at all, die, free-to-play, die. You know what I mean? Basically like that, right?
Yeah, kill the poor.
Here's the thing. When he went into the battleground, he's in a silver battleground, literally the first rank of battleground. So, of course, he's playing all the worst players in the battleground. That's like me being a global elite Counter-Strike player and making a smurf on a silver account and just going tapping heads and going 44-0 like he did in the battleground. Of course you're going to go 44-0, you goof. Come on. It's freaking, you're in a, you just spent 15 grand and you're playing against a bunch of silvers. Wait till you...
Well, wait a sec. So I don't understand what that makes sense of. So like if you didn't spend 15 grand... Does that mean that, like, you're just not going to be able to get as far up there? I mean, like, yeah, obviously that's true. Like, what he's saying is true that, like, yes, obviously whenever you first start off playing the game, you're going to be matched with people that are lower. And what I'm assuming with the with the MMR system in Diablo Immortal is that it will slowly match you up against more whales over time. Is that right?
Well,
like this seems.
I mean, that might be their system, but so I played Raid Shadow Legends. You'd be happy. I've spent less than $10 on it. Excuse me, if even that. If y'all can tell, not a really big fan of spending money on these games. But anyways, like so, just through a lot of time invested in the game, you know, I got champions. I got lucky. Like I. Kind of like in Diablo Immortal, right? I got these legendary gem shards. Sounds similar, right? And you can get those by just like, you'll get very few, but you'll occasionally get one just by like logging in, stuff like that. Like logging in, maybe doing certain quests or completing the campaign. So like, I have like, I've gotten probably like maybe four. And I would wait until, like, there was a special on, like, it's like, oh, if you use a legendary shard, there's a 10% increased chance that you will actually get a legendary hero, right? Which is what everyone, what you want. And so through it all, I've managed to get two, right? And I was like, cool, awesome. I can't remember if I got another one. Like, if you log in, like, 180 days, you'll get one. Yeah, half a year, 6 months. Have fun. But... So I like, you know, and I level them up, like, because it does a great job of, like, if you leave and come back after a while, you get all this energy, which is energy you have to use to play the game, blah, 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 get all that stuff. Point being, so I just have my guys running, getting gear with all this energy I you know, had accumulated from when I was gone. And so it's pretty decent. And I do the arena, right? Which is like one of their big things. Like that's their PvP. So I'm in bronze because if you don't play, your rating slowly declines because people can still attack you. And yeah, to this point, it's like, even though my stuff is geared, much like a whale would be, I just plowed through all the bronze. Like, it was ridiculous. Like, some of them would just, they would try and did absolutely nothing. Like, their defensive teams, absolutely nothing. So that's how I kind of see this. It's like, yes, you're going to, until you, like, rank up high enough, you're still going to just... absolutely annihilate them, but that still promotes pay to win, right? Because that still feels good. It's like, wow, I just totally rolled these people. And then I couldn't even get to gold. I almost got to gold, right? Because that's the rent. Because then guess what? I was getting rolled by people with all these legendary heroes who perhaps have spent money. So I'm a little iffy on this argument, but just quick rundown. That's kind of to me what it seems like. So let's see what he's got to say.
It's like he's saying that money equals skill. Yes, effectively that's right. And so yeah, of course that's what's going to happen, but I don't think that's the only thing that happens. Like it's not, I'm sure that, like, and also, like, in that mindset, if you're only getting matched up against other whales whenever you get into the higher ranks, then that would logically mean that unless you spend money, you can't get to the higher ranks. You see what I'm saying?
You get to the top.
Like,
of the-
so his argument actually explains what the problem is.
I agree with that.
Brother, wait till you come to the legend rank and you get up there with the pay-to-play players. Let's see what happens then.
So all of the pay-to-play players are...
Yeah. Y'all seen my videos, hopefully. If not, please check them out. This has been my whole thought on the PvP since day one. Get everyone who, right, basically break it down on how much money you spent in the game, have them play each other. It seems like this naturally works it out, because guess what? If you spent money, you'll be able to make it to the max league, right? You'd be the equivalent of like a World of Warcraft, like the Gladiator, right? The top, the best of the best. You know, you're not necessarily the best, you're just the best at spending most money. That's still also obviously highly unfair. But you're starting to see, right, how this can be, well, you know, you're still having fun, you're still competing. Eventually, like, you know, in the battleground, you'll still, you know, occasionally fight other way, you know, a whale, because they're just plowing through y'all to, like, keep advancing the rank. That is still not fun, right? That inherently is still a major problem, because that one person is going to be wrecking the team, and they can literally tip the balance.
The high PvP rank? I mean, I don't know, guys. I feel like that's a little bit problematic. Shit!
Let's see what happens then. You ain't gonna be running over players like that. Like I said, it's different versions of the game, different right. places. I also enjoy playing mobile games as a free-to-play player. It makes me feel good inside to smash somebody who is a pay-to-play. So there's different ways to look at it. There's different fun to be had. I personally love the system of running a rift, having a chance at finding something. I'm a gambler. That makes me happy.
And that's it. Oh, I'm sorry. He just paused for me. My bad. I'll let him say it.
That's I don't think that surprised anybody, number one. Number yeah. two, that's the problem.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he just said it. He's like, oh, I'm a gambler. I like running rifts. That's my whole point. You know what I mean? Like, that's the whole thing. It's a gambler, yeah.
Vindication. Yeah. Duh. Fun stuff.
Of course that's what it is. That's the problem. Is it? It's a game. This game does not make sure that people are 18 years old. It does not have any verification. Like, I'll give you this. If you go into Caesar's Palace, I guarantee fucking to you, in Las Vegas, they're going to make sure that you're not a kid. There's not a lot of kids that probably get onto the fucking the gambling floor. And they just, accidentally, you know, we got a 14-year-old in there. That doesn't happen.
Makes people happy. If people enjoy mobile gaming,
not a fan
so
of gambling,
be it.
But
all
there's
the
a
hatred
spectrum.
Doesn't need to be there, because it's useless. It's not that important. Like, you can just move on. Just
if it's not that important, why you spend $50,000 on it? Why?
Spoiler, I think you spent a little bit more than that based off the title of the video, but I'm sure we'll get there.
So it's obviously that important, right? So, like, that is just, in my opinion, in the garbage, number one. Number two, why is it that important? Because if the game does well, if these games perform well, then more games will come out that do the same thing. So anybody who is a PC gamer, anybody who is a gamer in general, I personally don't like this distinction between mobile gamers and PC gamers. I think this is stupid. How many of you guys play games on your phone and also games on your PC? Like, I feel like most people probably do that. Me? Yeah, most people do that. This is like, I remember Keemstar, always annoyed me whenever he would do this. He's like trying to start like, it's YouTubers versus Twitch streamers. What the fuck are you talking about, Keem? I'm doing both of them all the time.
Yep.
Like, most Twitch streamers upload to YouTube. Most YouTubers stream on Twitch.
Yep.
A lot of them. It's just weird. Oh, present. He's in chat. JT, what's up, man? How you doing? We've got your video on. All right,
don't
let's
play
watch
the game.
It.
You don't need to talk bad about it, because people like me and mobile gamers enjoy the game. Like, straight up, you can be free to play.
I think people can enjoy the game, right? And, like, the thing is, again, I feel like saying that you like gambling, and, yeah, he's here. Free advertisement? As I said, I don't mind watching people's videos as long as they're good. I don't care if they get advertised. I think that's fine. I watch. I link everybody's video that I watch. Yeah, that's okay. Yeah, it's that's whatever to me. I don't give a shit. And so this is the way that I see it, right? Is that, like, it's the gambling feature of the game that I think is problematic. I mean, the rest of it is whatever to me. Like, I don't care if he wants to spend 50 grand on a game. He can do whatever he wants.
In this game and have a blast. I have 10 real life friends and they play free to play and all of them love it to the highest extent. I also have 3 of my very best friends in real life who have all invested over 5,000 in this game.
Dude,
and they love it. They're having an absolute blast. There's
like, y'all, if I were to spend that kind of money on a game, I have some people at my house who would probably break my kneecaps and leave me for better pastures. Now, don't get me wrong, it'd be one thing if I was, you know, raking in, you know, $1 million, then it's like, oh yeah, 5,000, yeah, that's your money, that's your play money, sure. However, that's not the case. That is a significant amount of money to me, as I'm sure it is to many of you. Like, that's, I don't know, just whenever I hear that, I always think, it's like, oh yeah, must be nice. But anyways,
that's great, but, like, I mean, you've got to keep in mind that, like, this has to be, to a degree, like, a personal experience. Because, like, if it's not a personal experience, then why is it that there are so many other people that feel differently? Why does it have a 0.3 on Metacritic if it's such a good game?
Something's up.
Well, maybe it's not a good game. And in my opinion, like, I'd actually be curious to hear how he feels about the actual game itself. Because I think the fundamental game is bad. Like, he said he played Diablo 3. Well, he should be getting a lot of nostalgia running the Rifts. Because it's the same thing.
All right, for those who don't know, my opinion towards the game is I enjoyed the combat. I was having fun. My biggest complaint, aside from, you know, the spending the money, the incentives to spend money, was the level locks out of zones, because I'm like, there's not enough story content, there's not enough quests, right? Like, the side quests don't open up until you're 60. It'd be great if they had those, at least those opened up while you're going through the leveling experience, you know, while you're in the zone. Or maybe they do, but I know, like, the zones change up on a day-to-day basis. So, you know, I'd complete, you know, it was bad with starting with Biofin. And I actually loved quite a few of these zones. Biofin was one of my favorite. And I beat the story, you know, that story chain in that area. And it's like, cool, well, you need to get, like, 4 more levels, and then you can go. I was like, dude, what? Why, aside from running bounties, like the daily, you know, bounties, complete those, give you tons of XP, I don't want to just farm Elder Rifts like crazy. One, because I'm not dropping money to do Legendary Rifts, because I don't want to. I'm not going to support that. Like, it was this major bummer. Hated it, but again, that's my opinion. I love the combat. It felt impactful. I actually really enjoyed my Necromancer. I was having a lot of fun with it. But, I think I like the game, the base game, a little bit more than Asmongold. Still had my issues, but all in all, it was really the end game getting there that really, I've said this before, it just felt like a really hollow victory.
Different perspectives, you know what I mean? So, it's weird to me because when you've only played PC games, you don't understand that itch that mobile gamers have in all the different ways that they do enjoy the gaming. So
I feel like that is, like, the worst sentence I've ever heard in my entire life. Like, do we not understand the itch? Is it the itch, or is it something else that people refer to it as? The itch is a gambling addiction? I mean, I don't know. I feel like that's not good, man. It's Gamba. Yeah, number one, it's Gamba. Number two, like, I don't think that, like, why would somebody who plays why would somebody who plays mobile games, or sorry, PC games, not be able to understand this? I feel like anybody could understand this. Like, it's not like it's hard to understand at all.
Yeah, that's what it is. I mean, I don't really want to go on too much more. I just think that all the hate on Diablo Immortal isn't necessary, because this is the best mobile game I've ever played and ever seen.
But, like, the problem is that even if that's true, there's still, like, I mean, and that's fine, right? I'm going to go back. I'm going to listen to what he said a sentence ago, right? Like, there are a lot of people that have said that. In my opinion, I don't play mobile games. I don't like them. Why? It has nothing to do with the monetization. It has everything to do with, I just don't like playing games on my phone. The screen's too small. It's like this. I don't like doing that, right? And so it's just that's all. I don't like the controls and like moving with my thumbs, etc. There's nothing negative about mobile games, right? In my mind.
To each their own. I get it.
Games, you don't understand that itch that mobile gamers have in all the different ways that they do enjoy the gaming. So, yeah, that's what it is. I mean, I don't really want to go on too much more. I just think that all the hate on Diablo Immortal isn't necessary, because
this is the
best mobile game I've ever played and ever seen.
People just don't like it. And like, for example, I think that if you completely ignore, and this is something that a lot of people say that I do disagree with, if you completely ignore the monetization and you don't care about the monetization, like, here's a good fucking question. Is I watched this guy's stream one day. All you were doing, man, was running Lasso over and over. That's garbage. You're just beating a fucking target dummy. You just beat a target dummy. And then, by the way, and I'm sure, like, if I pull up his VOD, I watch this for like an hour. The rock didn't spawn that you had to get behind. And then people were dying. And then I think somebody, might have even been him, said that, like, y'all got to spend more fucking money so you don't get killed by this goddamn explosion. I saw this shit.
Yeah. No, thank you.
Yeah, I knew what this was. Show the bot. That's what it was. Because people were getting killed because they couldn't fucking afford to get enough health. That's what it was. And so don't you think that it would be a better game if after you killed Lassol, you would fight something that's not Lassol? I don't know. I mean, like, am I crazy here? Am I taking crazy pills? It's nuts. So that's what I don't like. That's what I really have a problem with more than anything, is that kind of stuff, man. It is just spend money. Yeah, it's just, it's bad gameplay. It's gone. The fight sucks. I mean, what do you want me to say?
I do agree with that.
On stream? I don't know if he's in chat.
I thought he was in chat. The Lasso raid was very disappointing, in part because pretty easy, like the mechanics. And don't get me wrong, I will take into account that, you know what, I might be wrong because it is the first raid, you know, and it's, they want to do a soft open to this whole idea of raids and, you know, the heliquary. But one, as soon as you go in, the boss immediately like aggros, so you have to be very careful. So it's incredibly annoying to pug. I think you should fix that. Like, give a little, like, buffer area just to go. Then you go in, and then, of course, like, you know, the wall pops up so you can't go back into it. Easy fix. And so I'm like, okay, pretty easy raid boss, maybe to get everyone adjusted. But, dude, come on, the bugs? Like you're saying, like, I explained, the rock doesn't always spawn, so, like, half the warband or the raid group dies. So now everyone's trying to res everyone. It's very stupid. The boss kind of jumps around, and I'm not talking about the actual jump, like, ability that you'll see. There's a big red circle. Move out of the circle, you're fine. No, like, they're attacking, and then they just kind of, like, glitch move, you know, Jason Voorhees style. So, again, I get it. It's like a intro raid to get people kind of into it. Just not a fun fight, and the fact that, like, you tell people, like, hey, you should kill Lassel, right? It's one of the achievement quest points, but it comes up so early. Like, you're, I think I was in like level 30 or something, but my combat rating was nowhere near what it was supposed to be. Maybe in my level, like the 40s, whatever. I don't remember. I just remember my combat rating was in like the mid 300s, low 300s. And it's like 425, I think, or 420 is the preferred combat rating. Basically, that means if you go there below that combat rating, you need to be very good at the mechanics, because otherwise you get one shot, which is, I got basically one to two shot by everything. Especially when the adds spawn, they shoot the little fireballs. I was done. I still got it done, thankfully. But yeah, I think, I don't know, they need to fix the bugs. Because I'm really hoping, like, that is like end game PvE content I was super excited for. You know, I'm like, man, they could really do a lot with this, and just super buggy, very disappointing. So fingers crossed it gets better, but yeah.
Blizzard's one of my favorite companies of all time.
Oof.
So
risky to say.
They make a mobile game, I personally couldn't wait for it.
I was excited to play the game too. I mean, like, I think that everybody was. Like, I love Blizzard. Like, I mean, he's probably around my age. Looks like he's a bit older than I am. I'm 31. And so, like, yeah, I feel like most people felt this way.
I love all Blizzard's free-to-play games as well. Like, I love all the Diablos. I personally can't wait for Diablo 4. I'm probably going to stay up for 72 hours and grind
Jesus.
It there and
there it
stop.
Is.
Like, I'm pumped up all for right. Diablo 4. However,
I just want to know what he does for
Diablo
a living.
Diablo Immortal as well. And it has made a great game. Like, whenever I'm traveling, if I'm in the airport, I can whip out my phone. I can play Diablo Immortal. I can't do that with Diablo 3. I can't do that with Diablo 2. You simply can't do it. This game is for mobile gamers. The fact that you can spend money.
I don't understand this distinction. I just don't get it. I don't get, like, why are mobile gamers different than PC gamers? Because in my mind, it's the same thing. It's like mobile gamers, PC gamers, these are all the same people. Like, what it seems like to me is that this is like a secondary definition that, like, because you can assign this definition to something, everything outside of that is okay. You see what I'm saying? It's like, this is for mobile gamers, so it's different. Well, why is it different? Like, what? Like, there's no intrinsic reason that mobile games have to be pay to win or that they have to have gambling in them.
Yes. Yes, to the fact that no, they don't and perhaps shouldn't have these pay to win aspects. It is one of those that it's just become so commonplace that, right, I guess that's the whole point. It's that's the primary distinction. You hear mobile game, and I always immediately think lots of in-game transactions. Lots of, like, money you're going to be needing to spend. You know, you're going to be getting bombarded with ads. Thank you, Raid Shadow Legends. Again, I did kind of enjoy that game. But, yeah, like, at the end of the day, you're playing a game that's much more predicated on incentivizing you to spend money, perhaps more so than a PC game. Now, granted, thanks to Diablo Immortal, that might be changing as the two worlds begin to cross over. Really unfortunate. But, yeah, I think, in essence, it's not really supposed to be a difference, but that is the difference. Like, I almost see it as, like, different gaming cultures. It's unfortunate, but that's just what it is, right? If you're like a hardcore mobile gamer, then you're like, yeah, of course you have to spend money, right? It's what kind of mobile game wouldn't? Like, yeah, it's free to download. And so, you know, you just maybe drop some money here and there. But if you want those bonuses to move forward, then obviously that's what you have to do. And you don't have to do it. You're just going to be slower catching up. Now, that's always the key factor, right? I believe Stu Gaming was the one who's really discussing that. It's like, well, it just slows you down a bit. It's not just a bit, it's a whole lot. But that's my two cents on it. Let's see.
There's nothing about mobile games that makes it fundamental that they have gambling or pay to win inside of them.
It's just become accepted.
Nothing.
What? It's part of mobile gaming. Yes, you can spend money and advance the character, and your character can have more stats in this game. Does that help you against free-to-play players in any way?
Yes.
No, it doesn't in this game.
What?
There's nothing about spending money that gives you an advantage over free-to-play players.
Yeah, well, how do you say that if, like, you just saw the video of Rich killing people? Like, I mean, that's obviously an advantage.
44-0.
I'm assuming that, like, the different levels, and do you get different stuff from, like, the levels in PvP that you get to? Like, I don't know if there's, like, a payout for PvP or something like that. I have no idea. Like, I didn't do PvP, so I can't be sure about that. Yes? So like, yeah. All right, well, let's say, so you get more money, you get more stuff from PvP. Rank rewards, yeah. So, like, if you... So, like, you've already created the foundation that the reason why Rich didn't get to... the reason why Rich had that game is because he didn't get to the rank that he should be at. And the rank that he should be at is a high rank. And the reason why he would be at that rank is because of his gear. And his gear is because of his money, which would imply that people that are all at this high rank spend a lot of money.
Yes.
So if everybody is at this high rank that spends a lot of money, and then all of those people are then getting rewards for that, isn't that a distinct competitive advantage? Like, it's just like, it literally doesn't make any sense.
A better character than free-to-play players, but you're never going against free-to-play players. In the battlegrounds that I'm in, I have never once played a single player that hasn't spent under $3,000 to $5,000.
What?
I don't play any players that have ever spent under $3,000 to $5,000 in any of my battlegrounds ever. You can come in my stream. You can watch them. It's at twitch.tv/JTisAllBusiness. There's never any free-to-play players anywhere to be found. There's never, you know.
Well, because you farmed them all the way up there, though, right?
Yeah, that's the only way. It's like, if you're recording the PvP at your current level, like your max level, then yes, obviously, right, that's the whole point, is you're now only facing other whales. But getting to that point, you were probably cleaving and weaving all these free-to-play players, because that's what happened to me multiple times. That's why I hated the battlegrounds.
So, like, this is kind of, like, what the issue is. Is, like, so, yeah, he farmed them all the way up to the rank that he was at.
Oh, yeah, see?
I can guarantee you probably at his first BGs, and also on the way up there, he did pay money to do that. And also, like, yeah, isn't that a problem in itself? Yes, I would say so. And beyond that, so, like, what he's saying is, like, in PvP, if you're not the rank that you want to be, the obvious solution is to spend money and then you'll be that rank.
Meaning all these players are starting to catch up. Now, once players get to the max rank, then the big heavy whales can duel it out. Some people enjoy that. Me personally, I enjoy that. I like having a maxed account. I like the fact of grinding. I like the fact of spending money to max out the account to grind against the other players that spent money to max out their account.
And with as much respect as possible that I can give, is this is the targeted audience of Diablo Immortal, right? Again, to each their own, right? If you want to pay to win, that's fine. But these, right, as JT here, is the ideal person, right, that they want to get.
And just go to war. Like, that's fun to me. It literally gets my adrenaline going. And
I think that's fun too. Like, especially, like, yeah, like, you're all geared out. Everybody on your team is geared out. Everybody on their team is geared out, and you're ready to just fucking, like, big dick. But I think everybody likes that. The only thing is that people would rather be geared out from grinding. That people want to be able to grind the game and not their job. Everybody would agree with that.
I simply enjoy it. So, yeah, that's that. I also enjoy being a free-to-play and doing things in free-to-play mobile games as well.
Okay.
Now, what I was saying is, me being a pay-to-play, how does this affect the game of Diablo Immortal? How does it puncture a free-to-play player's, like, gameplay? It doesn't. The only difference is the pay-to-plays can get better gear and waste their money on a mobile game, and the money just goes into the mobile game, into Blizzard's pocket, and they get nothing.
That's the problem.
Out of it, but they get enjoyment and happiness, and that's what they want to do, and that's what they choose
well,
to do.
Well, it's not that, like, yeah, I get that, but, like, is it necessary to spend money to be happy? And also, like, if you have to spend money to be happy, it doesn't necessarily have to be gambling. You see what I'm saying? Like, yeah, it doesn't have to be gambling at all. I don't understand this. And also, like, it's just...
Basically, it's a maddening, how I say it, it's a very frustrating or maddening kind of ideological belief that, yeah, we are doing this for you, the free-to-play players. Us giving money will keep the game alive, and it makes sure everyone can enjoy it. And part of that is true, right? Because you look at a lot of MMOs. Why do they die? Well, people stop playing, and then they spiral, or people think the game's dying, and then they leave, which then causes it to actually die. So yes, in that very literal term, by dumping, like, you know, the whales dumping all this money into the game, then yes, that is providing some form of, you know, constant revenue stream into the game, and, like, you know, oh, it's, you know, the game's still making a profit. I think what a lot of people have an issue with is that should not be the prevailing ideology in games. Like, well, make it pay to win, and that way us few whales can basically be the heroes who dump all this money into it to make it free to play. Our only price to you, the community of the game, is that we should be able to one-shot you or basically dominate you, no problem. I just don't think, from, again, a similar background to Asmongold and JT here, JT All Business, I believe, that's not what was always motivating to me for games, is that no matter what, you know, equal footing, unless, like, someone's rated more, whatever, you know, that they're expected levels of difference, but nothing like this whole pay to win BS. I don't think it's a good ideology to follow. You know, it makes you feel better, like, I'm doing this for the people. No, not really. At the end of the day, you're doing it for yourself, right? You're doing it because, as he said, you know, you like to grind, you like to spend money and see that reward, right? You like to get that little dopamine release from spending the money. It is not a, by all accounts, it is not a healthy way to really play games, because now it's, you're equating happiness, right, success in the game, with spending money. That is what mobile games and any game that relies on microtransactions is going to be hoping for. That is not what it should be about. It should be about, oh, time spent, you know, like a classic World of Warcraft. Time spent doing dungeons, then to raids, right? Everyone knew who you, like, your guild was, right? Or even in his career, right? Like, you know, Counter-Strike. You know, I'd say it was a pretty successful professional Counter-Strike career. Same with being on Wreckful's guild, doing the arenas. Like, that, to me, is successful, and that warrants respect. Dumping tens of thousands of dollars into a video game to buy that respect, right, or expect people to appreciate you for all that, that doesn't do it for me. I don't think that is a healthy ideology to get behind.
Obvious advantages to being pay to play. There are obvious advantages to engaging in pay to win. Because if there wasn't, you wouldn't do it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I mean, come on.
Dude, so who cares at the end of the day? You know what I mean? It just doesn't, it simply doesn't matter.
Well, I think a lot of people care, because, like, if they let it happen, all of the other games will be like this as well. Because if you allow games to be like this, then why would other companies not do the same thing?
Yeah. That's my whole point, right? It's, as a company, as a business, it'd be stupid. It's like, we could be making 3, 4, 5 times as much profit if we were to follow Diablo Immortal's, their strategy. And people, you know, if you don't, people might be like, oh, we respect you and everything, but that's not going to pay the bills at the end of the day. So, yes, these pay-to-wins and following in this kind of ideology is hurtful because it is now motivating other games to follow suit, which ultimately is going to just hurt the community. It's going to be overall just asinine. And you're like, well, if you don't want to spend money, then don't. It's not about that. I don't want to be going up against people who have the money, who have the time, predominantly the money, to just spend tens of thousands to do nothing but legendary rifts to be the best possible right gear. That I mean, you can see it, right? 5536, right, is a resonance. That's not fun. It's like, well, eventually, you know, you'll just fight other whales. It's like, yeah, but I'm that person who you stomped over for three matches until you got out of my bracket. That's not fun. Because guess what? When you leave, you're like, well, see, it's over now. It's like, no, because there's other whales who are coming through. It doesn't ever go away. And you can say, oh, well, you're just complaining that, you know, you get a free game and that it should all be free. It's like, I'm not saying that. I would happily pay $40, $50, even $60 for a game. The Battle Pass, I'm actually fine with Battle Passes because the benefits usually aren't, like, phenomenal. Like, you know, it's usually, like, aesthetics, stuff like that. Just the general idea of pay to win and its effect on the gaming community just doesn't do it for me. I don't see it being healthy for the game in the sense of having like fostering a decent community as well as just its effect on other games in general. And I think this really is going to start affecting, impacting video, you know, other video game titans in the industry, especially in the US or Europe, to an extent and to a level that has not been seen before. So This is going to be really interesting to see what comes of it all.
Because it clearly makes a lot of money. He spent $50,000 on the game. That's a lot of money. So why wouldn't you make the other games like that as well and give people like that the ability to spend money to gain power in the game? It doesn't make any sense. I think it would be logical to do that. Yeah, any reasonable person would do that. So massive justification, go, my guy. It's like someone convincing someone they've been scammed.
Yep.
I mean, that's that. As far as this account, as my account, you will never see me in any competitive way of a free-to-play player. If anything, I'm helping out all free-to-play players.
Help them out. The hero.
I'll run dungeons with free-to-play players. I'll help them get better gear. I do this stuff on a regular basis. Not only that, since I've spent so much money in this game, I actually have...
Look, the Koch brothers donate millions of dollars to charity every year. They're still the Koch brothers, though.
Good one.
Like, this is just, this is not, yes, it's nice that you help people out. That's definitely a good thing. But, like, saying that you help out free-to-play players, the problem is, it's, like, you're not wrong. You're not a bad person for playing the game this way. It's not your fault. You didn't make the game. Now, you might have said that, like, oh, I want the game this way. Yeah, sure. Right? But, like, you didn't do this. It's the system. Yeah. He's not the bad guy. How are you the bad guy? You didn't do anything wrong.
I have extra gems of all sorts of stuff. By the way, I mean, I already got...
Oh, my God.
I got rank 10 gem resonated gem.
Oh, my God. That's so much money. I'm so upset.
Tons of extras. Yeah. So what do? I go to my auction house, my marketplace, and I put these gems in there for nothing. I hand these gems out to all the free-to-play players because that's the type of dude I am. I want everybody to get this stuff because why not? I don't need it anymore. So I'm like, hey, boys, if y'all are on my server, everybody's getting free gems. Cheapest price you can possibly get in the market.
That's nice for him to do that.
That is
for sure. It's a nice thing for him to do that. 100%.
But it's still the same problem.
Yeah, exactly. No. It's like the thing is, you have to admit, like that is a nice thing to do. I get it. I understand it. Yeah, the guy's high. I don't think he's high. I mean, it's just, yeah,
He is legitimately, seems like a really cool, nice dude. Like, other than I disagree with the whole spending pay to win ideology, he seems like a really cool, down-to-earth guy. And the whole helping players out, like next to nothing gems to kind of help circumvent that whole pay-to-win model that he is endorsing. You know, I do respect that. But to the point I believe Asmongold is making is you are still engaging in the practice of pay-to-win. So giving back some to charity does not offset all the negatives you're still doing. That's how I'm taking it.
And the thing is, like, I don't think it matters to him. I don't think this is some kind of like a grand ploy. I think he probably just gives out the gems because it's like, hey, I've got the money, I can do this, and it makes him feel good to do it, right? It's not that deep every single time, guys. But it's the fact that you can do it in the first place.
I'm gonna put up 8 gems at one time for you boys. Told my stream that I'm gonna do that. Anyway, it is what it is. Mobile gaming's fun gaming. It's a different style of gaming than computer gaming, but it's still amazing gaming. And sorry, man, I've been ranting on for so long. I just keep hearing all the hatred on Diablo Immortal when it doesn't deserve it.
Well, like, I would debate this guy on the quality of the game.
Oh,
like, see, fucking put everything else in the garbage. Like, pay to win, no pay to win, that's fine. But the quality of the game quality is a problem. That's what I don't like.
That's
what I would say more than anything else. Like, the game quality, like, how do you think that it's good design that you fight Lassol on different modes for, like, more health? And the only difference with Lassol with fucking 3 million or 9 million health is the amount of health. He does the exact same mechanics, and then he just doesn't spawn the rock that he's supposed to spawn. This is objectively bad. How can you say this is not, like, look, let me see if I can find it. I'm going to pull this up and see for myself. Lassol, Diablo Immortal, speed kill. All right. So let's see if I can find that Diablo Immortal Lassol speed kill. Oh, there's literally nobody even watching this. Yeah, never mind. There's nobody watching it. Nobody doing that. Holy shit. Quinn got the gem. I know.
Really the best mobile game that's ever been.
Yeah, nobody gives a shit, apparently.
Like, yeah,
like, nobody watches it. Not the Quinn thing, the fucking Lassol.
So is every mobile game on the market. And I actually matched this account out for, like, a fourth of the price I had invested in other games. Like, this.
That's just, Jesus. Like, but that's such a bad argument, in my opinion. So, if it's, I think it said, like, $50,000, right? So, this would imply that $200,000 is how much you spent in other games? I don't know, man. Like, here, it's like if somebody punches you in the head and then they say, you know what? I'm just going to slap you this time. This isn't really an improvement, is it? This is not a massive improvement. How about just don't hit me at all?
Game is not even that bad as far as matching it out to some people. You know what I mean? Yeah. Some people,
Again, already what I said. It's a bad ideology to follow through with. It's still, you can do all the good you want. You're still promoting and motivating these companies to engage in these bad practices. That's all.
Yeah, it's a ton of money. Well, guess what? Those people can be minnows or they can be dolphins. And if the game's good enough, then they will stick around and they'll play it because the game knows how to basically allow them to have fun and do what it needs to do to let them have a fun gameplay, basically.
I feel like one thing that I would ask this guy is, like, if he knows about the patent that Activision filed in 2015 that explicitly pairs players that don't spend money with players that do spend money in order to motivate them to spend money. It's a real thing.
I mean, and if not, they'll quit, right? They'll quit.
Yep.
This game
is Activision, not
a very long time, because I'm telling you, I've been around mobile gaming for a long time. Been playing mobile games since 2014. And I've been spending money in mobile games for a long time, and I've also had free-to-play accounts in mobile games for a long time.
Okay.
And I see both aspects, and I also see the view from a computer from only a computer gamer's aspect. That's why I wanted to make this video and hope that Asmongold sees it. And I'm sure, you know what I mean, with their personalities, I've been watching these guys for a long time, right? I know they're thinking like, oh, let's make fun of this dude or do whatever. Look, I don't care about that. It is what it is. They can make.
Well, we're not making fun of you, but I mean, to be fair, like spending 50 grand on the game is kind of dumb. Like, I would fucking say that to anybody. But, like, that's some dumb ass shit, spending 50 grand on a game. Oh my God. But like, no, it's just like, I feel like it is. It's such a bad mindset to have that, like, mobile games fundamentally should have pay to win in them, or that it's okay that mobile games have this in them. There's nothing, again, there is nothing intrinsic to being a mobile game that means that it should or it's okay that it has gambling pay to win features. There's nothing that it's, this is completely fabricated.
Yes.
Fun of me, I saw the video that Asmongold made against the Stu gaming guy, and I'm like, dude,
oh, we gotta
really?
Watch that
like,
one.
You're gonna stoop that low? Like, dude, you're like, I've just been a fan of Asmongold, so that one hurt me a little bit. I was like, really, bro? Like, you're gonna do that to him? Like, it's not necessary. Like, Stu has a lot of good points that I see from.
But that is the, oh my God, that is the whole point. Is Asmongold, and myself included, I know I'm more or less a nobody here. But it's one of those, technically speaking, Stu Gaming was right. It's still, I do not approve and agree with the method in which you're motivating this. And it's just like, well, this is mobile game. This is what I do. You only do it because that's what they're like, hey, can we do these microtransactions? And people were okay with it. So you're okay with spending all this money. There has to be some sort of benefit to spending money. It's like, well, you just get ahead a little faster, but everyone eventually catches up. It's just during that process, people still get screwed over, right? JT, all business, right? Just discuss, you know, previously discussed the whole PvP scenario. And, right, it's that whales are still going to be going through dominating these free-to-play players as they get to the rank up to be with the other whales. But that's the thing. It's a constant stream. And you can say, well, you know, again, and I appreciate this with Asmongold and Stu Gaming going back and forth, is they've been very respectful and professional about it, in my opinion. The Quinn and Stu Gaming video, that, different thoughts on that. But, you know, I think both sides have raised valid points. You just honestly just need a good old-fashioned debate now.
I'm a freedom.
Name one.
Plays perspective.
Name one.
You know
one.
What I mean? So it's like, He doesn't see the vision. He's literally blindsided to it, and so are
what
these.
What is the vision? Like, is the vision? I mean, like, I don't
make
understand.
A
like,
make a lot of money.
Vision? Like, where is the vision? Where are we, what are we looking at? Yeah, I don't understand. Like, it's just the vision of what, money?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, what the fuck?
Other computer gamers, they're straight up blindsided to mobile games. And they don't understand the pay-to-play aspect of it, but that's fine. They don't have to. If you don't like the game, don't play it. At the end of the day, it's that simple.
I agree with that. I think that's probably the main thing that you should do, but I think that people can express their dislike of something even if they don't play it. And I did play it. I got to level 60. I went through the campaign. I spent $2,000 or $3,000 on the game. Like, it's not like I don't have any context around this. Like, I clearly understand the game. And the reason why people don't like the game is because that they are worried that the game is going to impact other games at the same time. I think that's what
that's
the
it.
Main issue is more
that's
than
all it is.
But you don't.
Because if everyone says, like, you know what, Diablo Immortal, they did it, it's fine. Hopefully no one else says it. No, that is going to motivate others to follow in a similar path. Right, keep preaching it, keep going over it over and over again, and the more people become complacent or even okay with spending the transactions, the worse it's going to get.
Don't need to hate on a great game and make fun of other YouTubers because they're saying they're having a good time playing as a free-to-play player. I mean, give me a break. You're way past that, dude. You're way past that. But anyway, guys, I hope y'all have a wonderful day, and I am out of here for now. Peace out, fellas.
I feel like the way that I reacted to Stu's video wasn't really, like, mean at all.
No.
Like, yeah, I said he was wrong. I thought he was completely wrong about it, but I wasn't. I don't think anything that I said was, like, rude or, like, abusive at all. Like you can disagree with somebody, and at the same time, you can make a video talking about the person being wrong. Like, yeah, I think that he's 100% wrong. Like, he is literally 100% mm-hmm. wrong. But I don't think that I was rude or out of pocket with, like, anything that I said. Yeah, let me see. Stu's good. Yeah, everything's fine. Let's see here. Justify the money spent on the game as content. It'd make 30K a month on YouTube. Since he makes 30K a month on YouTube, maybe he does. Guys, really trying to buy his way back to the time when he was skillful and competitive, variation of Class Candy. Well, I don't know about that. I have no idea. Call him, he's crying. I would talk to him, sure. I don't care. Like, to me, I think that the main issue that I have with this is that these games, like, they have gambling in them, yeah. And they're marketed towards a younger audience.
And they are still predatory in nature. They are still trying to get you, incentivize you in a multiple ways, right? And this has been proven through psychology, right? These tips and tricks, if you will, of how to get your clients to spend more money. So there is an immoral aspect to this game that just seems to be overlooked. And it's like, well, no, it's still a fun game. If I want to spend money, I can spend money. It's like, yes, but you're ignoring the kind of predatory nature that these kinds of games are having. And I think that is an issue that is not being adequately addressed.
And there's not the same checks and balances that exist besides, like in a casino. Like, for example, I'll go back to the casino example. Like, if you go and you gamble in Las Vegas, there's not kids sitting at those slot machines. Yeah, there's not kids sitting at these slot machines at all. These are grown adults, and they check it, and they make sure that doesn't happen. Like, rating a game M for mature mm-hmm. or something like that, these games are marketed towards teenagers. Let's just call it what it is. They're marketed towards teenagers, and that's what they're always going to be. Smash, I was going to make fun of me, Wawa. I didn't really make fun of Stu at all, I don't feel like. I didn't make fun of him at all. Like, I was like, it's like making fun of somebody. I don't think anything that I said was mean-spirited. Because, like, yeah, I did make fun of him a little bit, right? It's like, this guy is, like, fucking off the deep end, right? It's like, we gotta bring this guy back to reality. Like, yeah, it's a little bit making fun of somebody. But it's also, like, just fucking fun, you know? Like, that's it. Read comments? I'll look at it real quick, okay, guys? Give me 1 second. It's just nuts, man. It is absolutely nuts to see this shit happen. And, yep, there it is. Let's see it. I'm gonna pull this one up. Right here. There it is, boys. I can't believe I just looted my first 5-star gem and it only cost me $25,000. Thanks,
oh my God,
for this authentic Diablo experience. For reference, it's about $15,000. That's pretty good. How many more does he need to go? Like, it's got to be like only 8 more to go, right? How many more? How many more gems does he need to get? Only 5 more to go? Only five more to go. Okay, there we go. I see it, man. I see it. I can't wait for season 2. It's nuts. And so anyway, this is what I'm saying about, like, with these games, right? Is that, like, a game like this, a game like Diablo Immortal, like, it's really the gambling that I have a problem with. I don't care if it's pay to win. If you want to spend $50,000 in the game to make some crazy badass character, that's totally fucking fine with me. The difference is that whenever you spend that money on a loot box, and on top of that, the game is marketed towards kids, and there are no real checks and balances to make sure that kids don't play these games.
Mm-hmm.
There's no real authentication.
I agree with
that. If you go to Las Vegas and you go to a casino, I've never been to one. But my understanding is that they probably do a pretty damn good job making sure that kids don't go in there. Yeah, I mean, this is a completely different fucking thing, in my opinion. Yeah, they do? Absolutely. And so, like, yeah, Stu made a video in response to you. Actually liked what you said. I'll watch Stu's video, and then maybe we'll watch the Channel 5 video, too. I said I was going to look at that in a bit, okay? And did you see the new Bitcoin crash? No, I have not seen that. How much is Bitcoin now? It was 20,000 whenever I looked at it before. Because casinos are strictly regulated. Exactly, and I think that's what it should be. And so, yeah, just have a badass character, maximum free-to-play game. Isn't it the same thing as you don't get to pay-to-play? Like, it's 18? That's not really that much less.
Okay, everyone. Yeah, quite a lot to take in from that. I think it was a great video. You know, all things being considered, the JT All Gaming, I believe I'm getting his name right. Hope so. Apologies if not. Here's a link to the video we just watched. But yeah, check it out for yourselves if you want. Be posting this on YouTube here soon. Great discussion. Appreciate you all for checking out. As always, I'm your host, Dr. Duality. Thank you for coming in, and I look forward to seeing you all in the next video. Appreciate it. Bye.